This is one of the coolest AI automations that I've come across. We're going to build a workflow using make.com that automatically sends you a newsletter on any topic that you want with highly relevant and recent links based on the time frame that you choose in your newsletter. If you like this video and want to learn more about building with no-code tools, check the link in the description to go to No-Code MBA and view all of our courses. Let's get into it. Before we get started, let me show you what we're going to build and what you're going to have at the end of this video. So here we are in Make, and we have a workflow that does an API call to exa.ai, which allows us to get links that are relevant to the topic we want. Then we're going to parse it. We're going to put those into an Anthropic Claude prompt to turn that into a newsletter. And then we're going to send ourselves a newsletter. So here's just an example newsletter that I generated using the query defined links about the Nintendo Switch, the latest news about the Nintendo Switch. And it's pretty cool. I think it did a pretty good job summarizing it. And then, of course, there's always a lot more that we could do with the prompting to get this newsletter to be in whatever style and format that we want. But pretty cool that it included these relevant links. To build this automation, we're going to use exa.ai. It's an AI tool that allows you to use AI to search the web and get relevant content as well as summaries of that content. And we're going to use make.com to actually build the entire workflow. And then we're going to use Claude from Anthropic to actually take those links and turn it into a newsletter. So here we are on exa.ai. And then when you create an account, you're going to want to go to the API dashboard. And then here in the API dashboard, you can play around with the API, put in different queries. The way that exa.ai likes to get queries is, for example, here is an academic paper about a recent advancement in quantum computing, instead of saying what is. So don't ask it as a question, do it as here is, and that's how it's going to be able to get you the most relevant results. Then you can do their neural search, keyword search, which is more like a normal Google search type of search, or auto, which it'll optimize automatically. You can edit the number of results. You can edit the types of results that you get. So if you only want tweets, for example, you could select tweets. The date range, this is really, really helpful. This is where you can set if you only want news stories from the last 7 days or today or the last month, whatever you're setting it to. And then you can add highlights that are going to be included. You can get a summary as well, which is really helpful. So this playground is really helpful just for playing around with the API call. Then over here on the top right, if you click the curl tab, this is what we're going to copy into our make.com workflow once you have actually generated the results and set it up. So you're going to want to go to your API keys, make sure you have this handy, and I'm going to jump over to make.com now. So here I am in my make.com workflow, and we have 4 steps here. First, we have HTTP, which is where we're going to do an API call directly to exa.ai. Then we're going to parse that response using JSON. You also could parse it just by clicking parse response here, but I set it up as a separate step. Then we're going to do use Claude to turn our links that we got from Exa into a newsletter. And then we're going to send an email to ourselves. And then we're going to go ahead and send an email to ourselves. So it's a very relatively basic workflow that we're going to set up. And I'm going to go through each step step by step so that you can set this up yourself. So the API call, basically the URL, this is provided for you in the documentation, which I'll show you real quick. You go to Exa and you go to Docs. We can see if we scroll down to the bottom and we go to the search, we can see the request URL right here. So that's the URL that we need. And then we can see there's 2 headers, accept application JSON and content type application JSON. So if we go back to Make, we can see we have the URL set. It's a post call, which is, it tells us that here in the API documentation. And then for headers, we have accept application/JSON. And And then we don't have to put content type application/JSON because we're gonna set that automatically down here. So we just have that. We have our API key, and this is the API key for your exa account. And then we want to go down. You want your body type to be raw, which is going to allow us to put in just this kind of block of code down here. Content type JSON, that's what I mentioned before. So that way you really only have to add this header and this header, the API key and accept. You don't have to add the content type header, because I think if you actually do add it, it'll cause errors. So just a note on that. So once you're in the playground here, and you're happy with, you kind of do a test run, and I can do one real quick. And once you do that, you're going to get a response. And once you're happy with it, what you can do is, as I mentioned, go to curl. We're just going to scroll down to data. Inside of those quotations, you would copy all of that and then paste that into make right here. So here's one that I've already done, which is pretty simple. It just says, here are the latest updates and changes about the Nintendo Switch. With a colon afterwards, it said that's kind of a best practice. And then these are just the kind of basic defaults that I have for this query, so I don't kind of do anything too fancy. Then, under JSON, what I'm doing is we're parsing the results, which is the data, the results of that. So in order to do this, if you're building it yourself, you're going to have to first put this in. You can right-click and click Run This. And then you're going to have results. So then you can go and put that in there. Then the same thing, you're going to want to run this. So you might need to click right click, click run just this module. And then you can go to the question mark up here, get the data, copy it all, and then put that in. So if you click just run this, you can paste in all of that data. And you need to do this so that each step, you can then get the results from the previous step. Then for Claude, what I have here, this is also a little bit tricky, but I'll explain how to do it. So first, you got to set up your Claude connection. You can just add your Anthropic connection and connect it with your API key. The model I'm using is 3.5 Sonnet, max tokens 4096. And then what I'm doing is adding a message from the user text, and I'm saying, please take the following news stories and turn it into a well-structured newsletter. And to do this, what you have to do, it's a little tricky. I also added kind of headers for each one so that the AI could parse it a little bit better, but it might not be necessary to really do that. But basically, I'm just going to show you how I do one. I'm going into the JSON, going into the results. And then if I select one of the individual results, because this is parsing, we have six results. So we want to show all of the results. So if I want the URL, what you do is that URL, and then what make is going to do is allow you to put in the number of the result you want. And then I can do the same with the title, put in number one, and then the same with the summary that it generated and put in number one. So then this is going to be the first URL, the first title, and the first summary. And you can see I do that for each one, 222, 333, et cetera. So you can do that as well on your side. And then I just give it some more instructions. So I said, respond with only the newsletter, make the content valuable. Each news header should have a relevant emoji, give a takeaway of why it's relevant, et cetera. Don't cut down on information for the news story. So just kind of giving more information about what I want here. Then I have an example, and I added an example. So I said, use this example just for the style and tone. And I use one of my own newsletters just so it's kind of in the style and tone that I want. So the more examples you can give, it's always better for Claude. So I hit OK. And then I also told it at the bottom to write it in HTML format in this prompt. Then on the email, what we're doing is we're just for now use sending. You can just search email, send an email from make, connect your account. I'm sending to me, and then the content type is HTML. And then all you're doing is pulling in that content text from Claude. And that's it. And then it's HTML, so it's going to send us our email. And then here is the result. Pretty cool, providing the latest Nintendo Switch news here with links to actually go to those actual links. And I've tested this with a lot of different topics, and it seems to work pretty well. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this helpful. Check the link in the description to go to No Code MBA to learn a lot more about building with no-code and AI tools. And be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get all of our future content right here for free. Let me know in the comments what you want me to build next. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.